what's up, everybody? Oh, I need to fix the chat still. That's stupid. Audie here again with another live stream of Project Octopus that I've been talking about for like a week. Let me turn this music down just a little bit too while I do the intro. I literally had the music on like 5, so I don't know what to do with this music. It's all so loud. Yeah, I appreciate that, Kaiser. You're one of the real ones that stick around. Man, it's been how long it's been since I've streamed last? 6 weeks or something? I've talked about it a little bit on my Discord. Let me update chat and stream real quick. Grab this. I feel like if I was on Twitch, that it would just automatically update the chat for me, and I wouldn't have to update this link every time. Or maybe there's a way to do it on YouTube, and I'm just bad. Neither would surprise me. There we go. What's that sound? I think that's... Yeah, that's paint.net yelling at me. I had to open it real quick for the thumbnail. Apparently the thumbnail I was gonna use was too big. So, had to shrink it down by half size. But yeah, anyway, what's up everyone? It's been a while, I would say. Even though I've talked to most of everyone here off stream. Why do I still have paint open? Let me see here. Let me do this. God, there's so many like tabs and stuff that I'm trying to manage. What do I want to do here? I want to close this. There we go. Okay. Yeah, so for those of you who haven't heard, I've been in the hospital for like 3 weeks, and I just got out of the hospital on last Saturday, so it took me like about a week or so to get my energy back up to do streams again. But also, I really wanted to play through this Project Octopus. Let me turn this down a bit more. I'm at this point where I have the volume at like 2, so I can't turn it down much more. Let me do this. Okay, at least that's probably softer for you guys. So, Project Octopus is a game that I've been working on for like a year and a half, I guess you could say, along with Nico. Hopefully my YouTube commands actually work. So, let me try these real quick. Did that work? Yeah, there we go. So Project Octopus, as it says there, is a... What? Kingdom Bot. Wait, why is Kingdom Bot appearing twice? Oh. Wait, oh, it splits it into two posts if it's too long? Oh, God. No, Ryan, this isn't Ellie Land we're talking about. This is Project Octopus, okay? I wasn't the programmer in it, so it actually finished within a reasonable time. I didn't know that, and it didn't tell me that was a thing, so I'll have to fix that later. Yeah, you have. Actually, we've been talking on Discord since, like, before Ellie Land, so it's been a while. But yeah, anyway, for the past, like, year or so, I've been helping Nico out by providing music to this game. So, I did get permission from her to stream it as well. She did most of the work on it. I just provided the music and then There are a few other community members who did, like, testing. They compiled a lot of the combat abilities and helpful lists. Literally every game project, Mario. I don't know what you're talking about. Like, every AAA game always takes at least that long. I mean, you should see Kingdom Hearts 3. Like, that game took 14 years. Anyway, I'm gonna have to fix the Kingdom Bot command later. Make it shorter. Let me close out of this menu. Go to the new game screen. Oh, my games? I finished Ultimate X Poker in, like, a few months. I didn't publish it, but it completely works. Of course, that's just, like, a basic poker game, so I don't know if that really counts, but it is a game. Anyway, though, we're gonna, this is not a blind playthrough. I have seen Octo play through, like, all of this, so I know most of what happens, but I don't remember a lot of the early game content. So, there might be some new stuff. Also, if I recall, World 1 is gonna be kind of weird. Actually, as a disclaimer for this game, this game was kind of made with Octo's perspective in mind. So, like, some of the stuff is geared towards only him. But besides that, like, the combat's really good. The balancing is really good. There's a lot of considerations for the gameplay. So I might actually have to, like, big brain strategize while I play this. No, I didn't do all of the music. I did, like, 90% of it, but then at the end, Nico was actually, like, out programming my music composing, so I had to go in the hospital right after that. So I was like, you know what, Nico, you just pick whatever you want at this point. So there's also a few other songs that Nico just chose to use herself. So you can, like, yell at me if you think something is DMCA, even though I don't know. I think most of the DMCA stuff has been taken out at this point. That's, like, the whole reason why I was trying to do so much music for it, so that we didn't have to worry about DMCA. But there's still a couple songs that could be a problem, like One Wing and Angel, for instance. I know Square Enix really goes after that one, and I know that's in this. Hey, what's up, Rahe? Rahe, I can pronounce it, I swear. Guy who quit from drama, that's honestly a mood. Alright, talk to you in a few minutes then. Okay, I'm just gonna get into it. The intro is interesting. Oh, I didn't even consider that. So, my plan was to play this in normal mode, but there is a very real chance that if you guys really want me to, I can burn my soul alive in hardcore mode. You know what, Ryan and Mario, you guys have a point there. I've had a lot of drama happen in my life. So, that name is kind of a mood for me, which is why I pointed it out. Do I play in hardcore mode? Does it warn anything about hardcore mode? I know what it is. I know what's different, for the most part. It disables a lot of your, your medals or something? No, I think you get, like, more metal slots, but you lose some of your more broken abilities, and the enemies are harder. So, I only watched Octo play it on normal mode, and after he figured out, like, the right strategies, it did seem pretty easy, but I don't know if I'm really out to torture myself in hardcore mode. Yeah, you right. You right, Ryan. You right. We could maybe like VC after I'm done streaming too, since it's been a while since we talked. So, first things first, though. Yeah, you have less amount of metal. You're forced to be level one, and enemies are harder. Yeah. Kaiser has it right. And you get less money, apparently. Oh, that sounds like hell. nothing like getting back in the streaming playing like hell mode. But do I do normal or hardcore? I still need like an answer. Okay, I'm fine. I'm just gonna do normal so as not to torture myself too hard. Yeah, Surge was testing it on hardcore mode, and I heard he suffered. So, let's just do normal mode. Why do you want a classic experience? Also, welcome back, Rahe. Choose normal mode difficulty. Sure. Would you like to skip the intro? Now, the intro. Well. Okay, I have to play the intro, but I might have to mute the intro because of the song that plays. This is kind of like a fake intro, by the way. I love how Mario only knows Surge from Baby Shark. He's also in my Discord server, so I don't know if he's gonna show up later in the stream. But I hope he does just to see that comment. All right. You'll recognize what this is. Okay. That's enough of that. I will read it with like the Star Wars vibe though. Project Octopus. It even has like the scroll section. Episode 420 Octonips. This is when I first saw this, man. I didn't even know what I was expecting. It is a period of demonetization war. Rebel YouTubers and Twitch streamers striking from a hidden base have won their first victory against the evil demonetization empire. During the battle, Smelly Octopus managed to steal secret plans to the empire's ultimate weapon, the Copyright Strike. An unjustified claim that Copyright Striked even Smelly Octopus's voice. Which actually happened in a YouTube video. Pursued by the Empire's sinister agents, Princess Zelda races home aboard her horse, a custodian of the Sheikah Slate that can save Hyrule and restore Kingdom Hearts, Ball of Darkness. And our story begins as Smelly Octopus prepares to play a video game dedicated to him. I almost ran out of room on that intro. I almost read it too slowly. Yeah, Ryan, it'd be Order 66 all over again, right? Wait, what? What happened? Where am I? This is obviously not my professional streaming room. No, seriously, where am I? Hey, Mario. You're right, but I still take offense to that because Time Tales is unfinished. This game's only better because it's finished. Which is a very important point that I can't discredit. Anyway. Kelly, this isn't funny anymore. Kelly's Octo's wife, by the way. Maybe this is what they call being transported to another dimension kind of deal? Or maybe I'm just dreaming. Might as well explore the area then. I'm sure I'll be waking up anytime soon. So, this is Project Octopus. Man, the memories of just like seeing this for the first time before all of these buildings were even planned out, they were just here. Oh, I should probably turn game sound back on. Yeah, that's important. Let me do that. No, I'm only using a keyboard right now. I do have a controller. I could try to play this on, but I don't think this game specifically really matters about keyboard over controller. So I'm just gonna stick with keyboard for right now. Also, strangely, you can like move around with the mouse, which is something that RPG Maker has built into it, which is kind of weird. Also, you can really see that everything is on like a grid. Wait. Oh. Wait, hold on. This is a problem. Yeah, it is kind of like, because it's RPG Maker. So it's like a specific engine that's meant to emulate RPG games like Pokemon and all of like the classic Final Fantasy, etc. games. This kind of worries me. Should I tell Nico about this? No, I was talking to Rahe on that, Mario. But yeah, your timing kind of, I kind of ruined your joke at the same time. Oh, it's a password locked thing. Okay, that's fine, I guess. I don't actually know the password to this. So, we're gonna say E space. Where's my P? Oh, there's no like period. Bad. Or am I just blind? And it's actually on here. I don't see it. It has arrows, but it doesn't have E. I can't do E period. Wrong password. All right, that's fine. E. Imagine if the password was Katamara. That'd be wild. All right, Rahe. Thanks for stopping by, at least. All right, so first thing, there's a mysterious cat sitting here. I didn't use... Actually, wait, yeah, that's a good question. Can I do that? Oh, it remembers. No, I can't, sadly. RPG Maker limitations, it seems. Remind me to have that be a thing if I ever make, typing sections in games. Anyway. Hello! Hello, cat. Hello there, traveler. Nico has wares if you have tentacoins. Oh, it's a shop. Wait, did you just say Nico? Yes, my name is Nico underscore thief. Totally not another underscore we know, right, Ryan? The best cat, sales cat out there. Nico, I'm so glad to see a familiar face. Not that I expected you to be an actual cat. Ah, it seems my glorious sales name is spreading across the land. I'm quite flattered, but I require tentacoins more than mere popularity. Wait, Nico, it's me, Smelly Octopus. Hello there, Smelly Octopus. Nico is acting like an NPC. Am I in a game? I am one busy feline, so I'll have to go back and tend to my wares. Feel free to talk to me if you want to view my fabulous wares. I'm not completely sure what is happening, but I think I'm trapped inside a game. Also, I need to take some, like, mental notes of a few things while I play through these early areas. Because I have some plans related to Project Octopus still, which I'll get into later when I get to a certain area. Well, I guess there's no point moping around. Might as well explore. I totally skipped a line of dialogue there. Feels bad. Like, oh yeah, there's actually a run function. Thank the Lord. Oh, did he really? Did he really start streaming? Beggars. Well, you know what? Screw it. I haven't streamed in 6 weeks. I'll tune into the stream later. But yeah, if you want to go check out Octo as well. I also have an Octo command now. though. Oh. God dang it. It's literally short by the hyperlink. No. Alright, that's fine, I guess. But yeah, anyway, he's streaming at the moment if you wanna like go to the stream, say hi. I don't wanna tell people to go watch someone else while I'm streaming, but like he's a really good streamer, so. Haven't gotten that far yet, Mario. Oh, I saw it, Ryan. I saw it and was gonna react to it, but like, I'm already 15 minutes behind on streaming, so I'll totally just react to it later. It sounded kind of familiar, I would say. Alright, anyway, this might be a bit of a different playthrough for me, because when Octa was playing it, he was playing it as, like, a blind playthrougher and also a surprisingly amazing tester and found a whole bunch of bugs that the testers even missed, so, like, big rip on that, I guess. But I can maybe talk about some of my ideas for a future project while I go through this. Starting with this thing, this Octosaver. Close to when Nico started building Project Octopus, I was gonna try to build my own, like, platformer gacha game, which didn't really work out because I decided to redirect all my time into composing Ellie Land and setting up my website. But I'm gonna, in this side story I have planned, I'm gonna have this Save Octopus play at least a bit of a bigger part. But for the meantime, it's just a cool save. Let's see, I believe this works too. Yeah, if you guys want to check out my website that's totally outdated but still has up-to-date music on it, but please tell me you actually work. Okay. See, I never know if Kingdom Bot is gonna work because it takes, like, 10 seconds for the command to register, which is a bit concerning. But, oh well. I do like that it says Kingdom Bot instead of, like, Nightbot, though, so I guess I'll take it. Alright, so I believe I just have to, like, explore this area to start with. See, if this was Game Maker, I could actually do, like, diagonal movement. And, my god, that would be amazing in this game. But maybe it would hurt the feeling of it. Yeah, so there's, like, a password emporium. You can get rewards in there. There's like, a crafting station down there. A restaurant sort of thing. Endcoin. That's used for the combat system, which will be talked about in a minute. Wow, I found, like, the one way I can't go through. Can I interact with this? There are 8 keyholes. Apparently not. Potion was found. Was this here before? Oh! I remembered this. I didn't realize Nico added this in. Okay, so a bit of lore behind the development. There is this one side quest that was like a Pikachu side quest for Fern, because Fern in the community is like Pikachu oriented and there's like a bunch of memes related to him and Pikachu. And when Nico was working on it, it, like, nearly corrupted the game and she almost lost a substantial amount of progress. Fortunately, she was able to restart, RPG Maker before that actually happened. But she had so many problems with trying to figure out why Fern was breaking the game, because Fern's, NPC had, like, a specific ID to it that was apparently the same idea as something the game used internally. So, like, whenever it was referenced, the game was like, no, this is internal code. Why the flip are you referencing this? So, she had to, I believe, either scrap this side quest or, like, assign a new ID to Fern, and that fixed it. And that was such a mess. And yeah, I do know how to dash Kyther. I can just hold down shift. I believe there's, if I go into the menu, if I go to options, is there, yeah, let me turn always dash on. Command remember? Do I care about, I guess it would go to it like right away. Think monitor FPS, don't care about that. Keyboard config could be interesting. I turned down the sound effect volume because I thought it was a little loud all the time for the music, or compared to the music, which is kind of my bad because some of my earlier songs were a bit quiet, but also some of the other songs that Nico used were like insanely loud due to how YouTube works with uploading. So, bit of both. Let me grab this. Ether was found. Can't go in here yet. Can't go that way, of course. Kyther, you can just go into the menu and turn on auto run. That might be better. If you hit X and then you go to options and then you can go to always dash. Gonna grab all these real quick. Aerith down, very important item. That's your revive item. That's a reference to Final Fantasy. But you can't go that way yet. I don't actually remember what's blocked off initially, since the last gameplay I saw on this was with everything unlocked. It'll probably take me like a good few streams to finish it. It's pretty dang long. Let me talk to you real quick. Hello, Noctis. Oh, that's just fishing stats. Okay. Yeah, this game has fishing in it, which you can fish at these holes, but there's actually, like, different music, different fish and everything. Really neat. I'm not gonna do this yet, though, because it's, like, gold farming stuff, which I don't need to do yet. 500 tentacoins. That's the currency of this world, by the way, tentacoins. Everything is, like, Octo-related, and all references to his community, so. Okay, so, while I try to figure out what to do next, which is probably just something simple, like, walk over here. Wait, no, I remember. I need to find the 8 world gates, I believe. Yes, there's 8 worlds in this game, and more bosses than I would probably even have planned for Dimensional Adventures, which is kind of wild. But alternatively, RPG Maker does a lot of the combat stuff for you, so it's not like, it's a lot easier to make bosses in this game than to have to, build them all from scratch, like I'm trying to do. Rip my free time. Maybe I think I go down and then, yeah, okay. Austin coins. I don't own the currency, okay? Never have. Yeah, I got it now, Kyther. I'm just being an idiot. Why do I have an itchy feeling I need to explore this place very carefully? See, I only played this game at, like, the world, not even world one, like, the intro to it. So it's actually been almost a year since I've played this, which is crazy to think about. Even though I've watched a lot of it and I've seen a lot of the development, I haven't actually played it. And I haven't even played normal games for a while. Yeah, so this is what I need to do. I probably need to talk to here. My professional gamer instinct tells me that there's something fishy with this one. I knew it! Not so octoblind after all, huh, Tentacru? Oh, wait. They're not here aside from Nico Thief, who doesn't know me for some reason. We're here, Octo. Just read chat. I can see the Tentacru chat. Hope you guys are proud of me. I'm reading chat for once. Ah, that's a meme. Yeah. There'll be moments where the Tentacru can dictate in-game events. The game will tell you when you get to involve the Tentacru in adventures, like right now. Now decide how much help you want to give Smelly Octopus. How much help will the Tentacru lend Octo? I believe Octo himself picked a lot of help just because he's a scrub. But I haven't seen the alternate dialogue, so I'm gonna see what this is. The Tentacru decided to give a little bit of help to our poor Octopus. Well, thanks for one measly potion, I guess. I think I did see both ways. New quest, into the unknown! Which is that World 1 portal, but I'm gonna look around a little bit more first. Mario, did you just use an Octothorpe followed by an Octothorpe? That's pretty meta. Alright, so a little bit about my side project real quick while I look around for treasure chests. Already got that one. What I want to do with it involves me recreating a bit of this area and also a secret area that we're going to get to after World 1. So I'm going to try to recreate this main hub theme, which I did not make this main hub theme, by the way, but I'm going to remake a version of it for my little side project that I have planned. Oh, yeah, and also, If you guys didn't hear that sound effect, you think this is DMCA? It's one of the Pokemon themes from Smash Brothers. Well, not a. I don't think Octa muted this on his, so I'm gonna assume it's fine. Question mark. All right, welcome back again, Rahe. Just like. Explaining some stuff about a future project and praying that I don't get DMCA'd at any point in this game, even though most of the music is mine. Wait, am I in a Pokemon game now? Speaking of reminding you of Pokemon, there's literally a Pokemon world. Not gonna lie, this is kind of epic. This is kind of epic. Hell yeah, I've said that before. Wait, Charmander? How did he see through those trees? Just wait there, buddy. I'm coming to get you. Into the unknown. Charmander in a pinch. Just gotta walk over there. Oh yeah, and the treasure chests are now Pokeball, which is great. Great little touch. Can't go that way yet. I can at least interact with this though. The extra thick bush is blocking the pathway. We only have some way to burn this bush out. Flip. Then again, I might just get banned off of YouTube for saying that, but I'm reading dialogue, I swear. Also, there's like a whole bunch of other memes related to Samurai Jack about extra thick. So, how the hell did you get here? Why am I talking to a flush? It's not like it's gonna answer me or something. Hi there, Octo! A magical Charmander here. What? Did you just talk? Of course I can talk. I always take over your streams when you step out. Well, this is a surprising turn of events. Also, these portraits were custom made by Derps, who is a great artist in Octa's community too. Or at least a lot of more. Oh god, now I have do I drop F bombs in my like pseudo family friendly chat? That's probably a terrible idea. I'm gonna ad-lib some stuff here, actually. You know, gotta keep it at least, like, low-tier swears. No, Mario, not derp. Derps with an S. With an S, like, derps, like that. Should probably, like, credit her too, but I don't know. Project Octopus has credits in it, so when I get through the whole game, you guys can see everything. This is also not my song, by the way. What the hell is that? I'm gonna be ad-libbing some stuff here. It's a Heartless. Quick, Octo. What am I supposed to do? Use your tenth keyblade, silly. When did I get this? Oh, ignore that typo that nobody ever fixed for some reason. Well, all I remember is that you quickly grab that weapon in me while you are getting sucked in the darkness of your computer screen. Well, I guess I have no other choice but to fight. Yes, I know the music is loud as Christ. And then mine is here and it's like too quiet. So there's gonna be a lot of sound shifting. Wait, what? You son of a sub, why did the game close? Extra me either. Hold on. Why did it? It literally not only went hidden, but it swapped over to Pirate 101 as a source. I'm dead. maybe it's trying to tell me something. Oh wait, no, that's the wrong thing. Why did window capture high? There we go. That's so weird. The only hotkey I have that hides window capture is like Control Shift W or some garbage. I have no idea why I did that. Okay, anyway, yeah, this is, like, tutorial. These are actual Heartless. Don't worry, Octo. Keep calm and focus on the enemy. I can teach you how to fight. Oh, I can skip it. I don't want to skip it. Wait, but I get, like, free turns if I go through it. I'll go through it. It's not that long. Teach me, Charmander. The key to winning these fights is to know your options and your surroundings. This is a battle screen. It might look hectic right now, but don't worry. I will ease you into it. Why do you have... Nico, why did you put a picture of a picture? Oh, I see. It has, like, the red outlines. Current status. Under the HP and MP gauge is the TP gauge. You guys are familiar with how RPGs work, right? Command menu there. I thought this gave you, like, extra turns to do stuff, but I guess I was wrong. The turn timeline might be important. Depending on the order here, it'll tell you who's coming up next. That's similar to some Final Fantasy games. Oh, I saw something about skilled gamers there. Probably should have read it. And then the enemies are just there. Interestingly enough, Mario, my plan was to have Mabby and Terrence on the left side for our project, and then have the enemies on the right. So this is like the opposite. Oh yeah, Mario, if, like, I know you probably will appreciate some of the memes in this at least. There's a whole lot of, like, references and memes in it. It's freaking great. Just like ours, honestly. I'm kind of surprised that they didn't even attack. See, someone offered to, like, clean this up grammar-wise, but apparently it never got done, so, like, ignored any typos. Watch out, Octo. Hey, wait, my turn was supposed to be first. What is this? Did I lose my turn doing that tutorial? Bad. Alright, so anyway, attack does basic damage. Each enemy has, like, an element weakness, which we'll get into later. Guard is actually pretty useful in this game. It can reduce damage by 50%. So you can do some cool things with that to, like, tank hits, etc. Items probably don't have too many yet. Just a couple I picked up. Restores various statuses and... And also, Final Fantasy VII reference. An item that Cloud could have used for Aerith. There's gonna be plenty of those. Also, Nico being the memester. Octopus has 420 HP and 69 MP. Let's not overlook that. Anyway, just gonna attack some dudes here. There's no, like, quick time actions or anything. Ouchie, ouch! Not really. Would appreciate some help fighting, though. Sadly, I can't join in because the Charmander joins your party hasn't popped up yet. That prevents me from joining the fray. For real? Insert Ryuji voice. I guess I gotta do this solo. Yeah, this is pretty easy, honestly. Now, I'm curious about something, though. Do I intentionally die in the tutorial to see if I get called a scrub? That'd be pretty funny, honestly. Oh god, I don't like how the arrow options are set up to go back and forth between the enemies. Like, you can use up and down here to go between B and C, but you have to use left to go to A, and then... Wait. Yeah, and then you can use down to go to B, but you can't use up to go to C. What garbage RPG maker, what is this? Alright, anyway, it's fine. We're just gonna attack this one and kill it. Oh, I forgot they have a chance of waiting as well. Wait, also... What? I'm hitting up right now, and it's not going up, but when I hit down, it goes up to the top enemy. Oh my god. How did none of the testers catch that? That's kind of bothering me. You have to go in opposite direction between these two. I knew I should have been a tester for this game. Had too much going on, though. Kind of like trying to design two of my own original game projects at once, so like... It was amazing that I even had time to make as much music for this. I'm not gonna worry about dying in the tutorial for right now. That's above my pay grade of free. Anyway, we got a bunch of items. The materia can deal damage of like a certain attribute, which can be important for trying to break an enemy. Oh god, holy flipping music back. There's gonna be there's a lot of like music imbalancing that I wish I had the chance to fix. No, you can do it if you want, Kaiser. I'm good. Take this, you little piece of demonetization. Well, that was pretty easy. Now I have to like turn it up again. God dang it. Here, I'm gonna shrink my screen preview down a little bit so I can turn the music up and down if I need to. You did a pretty great job, Octo. I'm so glad Kelly made me this keyblade. Now I get to kick some demonetized. Can I just substitute in demonetized every time there's a swear? Indeed, I wish I could have helped though. Don't worry, Charmander. With the two of us, we can defeat these enemies. Pikachu! Oh, this is actually Fern, by the way. Broken quest Fern before he broke that quest. Because he was in World 1. Looks like someone already managed to fend off some Heartless. A talking Pikachu! I sure can talk. Also, like, this game is not officially published, by the way, because Nintendo would absolutely body trademark copyright everything in this, as well as several other sources. Wait a minute. Is that you, Octo? Eh? Fern? Fern is here! It's time to Pika! I'm so glad to see you, Fern. I didn't believe it at first, but now I know you're an actual Pikachu, Fern. I'm quite glad to see you, too, Octo. Sadly, I'm a very busy Pikachu. You see, I also just woke up inside this strange world. Heartless are everywhere, and my Pika instincts tell me that I need to hunt them down. you know, to preserve the justice, to maintain the order, insert sock puppet Donald emoji. I wish we had it here. Feels bad. Mario, please, I only use low-tier swear words if you've kept up. So, we're both in the same situation then. I also just woke up in some random place. Well, I guess we got to work together to find a way home then. You should go and meet a new friend of mine. He's located south near the abandoned town. Abandoned? I tried to search for other Pokemon or humans around the area, but they're all gone. Not a Pika soul to be seen, aside from my two new friends. Alright, Octo. I gotta go out and eliminate some Heartless. Pika Fern out! Da-da-da-da. Guess we gotta go south and find this abandoned town. Let's go, Charmander. Charmander joins the party. Where's the fanfare? Hey, what's up, Enrique? I'm doing pretty good today. Well enough to actually stream, at least. Been pretty tired the last few weeks or so, but finally feeling up the stream again. My time to shine! Use, I don't know, Ember? Which, even though it looks more like freaking Blast Burn on the Charmander. Good work. Took care of that bush block in the way. Northern woods. Gotta keep heading down. Now, here's something I wish actually happened. You can't, unfortunately, go into these. I suggested making them for something. But you will notice in this game, there's not really a lot of, like, NPCs, necessarily. That's just, like, to probably cut down on time, because as Mario and I know, it's a lot of work to come up with a whole bunch of NPCs. So, it's mostly just like Octopus traveling with his friends across these worlds. And then the enemies are the real references. Now I have Charmander in my party. I should probably... I believe I can equip some stuff to Charmander here. Let me see. Guess I can't yet. Okay. Pokey MMO? You mean like what? I haven't played a Pokemon game in a while. I think the last one I played was like, honestly, no. Is that right? The last one I spent a good amount of time on was Omega Ruby, and I only got it for the nostalgia because I bought the original Ruby and absolutely love that game. I'm planning to also get Radiant Diamond. I haven't touched Pokemon Go, Pokemon Unite, the new Pokemon Snap I kind of wanted to get, but I haven't had time to play a whole lot of games, so I haven't been able to get that either. Yeah, I know there's a Pokemon. I know there's a Pokemon MMO. I know there's a Pokemon like online battle system where you can customize your team and stuff too. But like, I'm still a fan of Pokemon. I haven't had time to play a lot of games except for all the time that I waste in Yu-Gi-Oh. We don't talk about that. Anyway. Squirtle, Squirtle! Let me do the chatting, Octo. Char, char, char. I love how the sprite changes when talking in Pokemon language. So what did he say? He said he's Squirtle. Very helpful. That's it? Yes? Squirt! He said he is Fern's right-hand turtle, and he wants the train your DMCA... You're demonetized in the art of Pika demonetization kicking. Pika Ashbats kicking? Actually, I should use Ashbats. That's funnier. Ryan, if you're still here, you think that's a good idea? When anyone says, I can just substitute it for Ashbats, no one will know what I'm talking about, except for us. It'll be great. Although, this is gonna feel a bit weird actually fighting a Pokemon as a human. Well, I have type disadvantage, so you go for it, Octo. I believe in you. Squirtle, Squirtle! Octo tanked 2 tenths of metals. A tantamedal? It even has Fern's face and Nikothi's face in it. It seems that you can equip it and gain the power of the Tentacruel in the palm of your hand. You can equip tentamedals in the main menu. You can talk to Squirtle when you're ready to learn the art of Pika. Alright, so this is the in-depth combat system of this game. Nico actually took the time to take, like, every community member and turn it into a medal that has a different effect. And it's kind of amazing. It's so many abilities, in fact. So if I go over to equip on Octo, and I go to, oh, what was it? Is it equip or is it skill? It might be skill. Okay, yeah, it's skill. So he has two skills right now, so I can equip his EX, which is Tenth of Slash, and then there's all of these medals that you get in various ways by buying them in a shop later, and they all have different effects, and there's, like, 100+ of them. So imagine a character having, like, 100+ abilities that you can customize. Do I want the EX? Can I even use the EX yet? I don't know. Oh, did I equip them at the bottom like an idiot? Oh, I can just equip all of them. Okay. That's fine. Let me double check if there's anything I need. No. Okay, Charmander has everything. Yeah, I know I'm probably missing a few things. Clearly. I mean, I can't redeem anything yet anyway, but, like, yeah, up there. I might have to, I'm gonna have to walk around to get that since there's trees in the way. Alright. Okay, so I can't use any of those. I could fight some generic enemies here. I might do that at least once. There is a random chance. Oh, we can't leave. Dang, plot armor. Or, we can't go this way either. Sad. Okay. Keeps you on the path, I guess. Really wish we could, like, go into one of those houses or something. Heh, that's pretty convenient timing, then. That you're playing Pokemon. Wait, is there actually, like, invisible chests? Oh no, I don't want to hunt down invisible chests. What, like, around here somewhere? At one of these? Why can't I walk over those flowers? Ah, right there. What do you know? Our coin. Eh. That's gonna be... I don't really care about finding the secret items around here. Because I know how the game scaling is, and I know I'll have enough, medals by flipping World 8. I could have probably gone back to the gotcha to the shop first and used that R coin, but oh well. Materia in this game. Sword right here is teaching you the basics of Pika. You know what, Kaiser? I respect your dedication to find invisible items, but I'm not going to be doing such a thing. Unless I actually, like, struggle, but hopefully I'll be good enough. So yeah, you can use materia, if I go over to items, you can use materia on enemies to deal a certain attribute of damage, and then it helps them get closer to their broken status, because if you hit them with a weakness, then it'll advance their broken status counter. And once they break, I believe it, like, stuns them for a little bit, and you can deal bonus damage on them and stuff like that. Depending on the enemy, too. And then I could use one of these here. Maybe I'll just... there's plenty of healers around. I'm just gonna use Growl, because why not? Yeah, if you want to, Rahe, you could just go over to Octo's Discord and download it. It's not really... It's not gonna be published anywhere because it has too much DMCA, copyright, etc. material, but it's free for everyone to download and play. Even though it's breaking up that message, which kind of bothers me, but that's fine. So what is the benefit of hitting their weakness? It'll literally say it. The shield values will not inflict break. Break status stuns the enemy for this turn and the next turn while also allowing us to deal massive damage. Yes. But do I? Do you see? Wow. Literally use, like, the strongest attack this enemy has on Charmander. Alright, anyway, yeah, so I can use one more Lightning Materia, and it'll break him, and then I can use more attacks. So, like, Skill, I can use Scratch and Ember, it'll probably deal more damage. 240. I don't know why it, like, skipped Octo's turn right there. I guess Charmander's faster, and then I'll use Ember. 123. And then I can use Fern, which does electrical damage. The abilities also have, attributes on a lot of them. So, you can customize abilities to be beneficial towards certain bosses. Which is something that Octo kind of did, but he didn't really match up attributes necessarily, since there's a few metals that are just inherently good, regardless of attribute typing. Do 31. Stop bodying Charmander. Is this on one ally? Restores HP based on luck. Strength. Yeah, I'll use that on Charmander. Charmander, stop getting bodied. I could just stun him again with more materia, but... Yep, freaking at Sushi Spa. Oh, cool, he got paralyzed, I think. Or he was paralyzed and I just didn't notice. Why is... Charmander is getting so many turns. Why am I able to do that? I could Ember again. Doesn't matter. Oh yeah, another thing about the materia is that you can use them on any character. So, if you're running, like, Charmander, who's fire-focused, you can use lightning attacks to lower the break value, which is kind of nice. Yeah, it's, Project Octopus is, like, a pretty hefty file at this point. It's, like, 1 gigabyte, so... It's kind of crazy how much stuff was put into it. Be sure to, like, you have to, like, extract all and then run it, of course, because it's compressed. But... Anyway, I'm gonna use some of these material to make this easier and faster. Restored 1 MP. Lightning materia. Oh. 3 days left. That's a big ol' rip. Alright, one more attack. I can maybe turn this up just a little bit. Alright, so yeah, I got Water Materia. Pentacoin voucher, which I can turn in. You said you were ready for the second lesson of the Pika. Our next goal is to find Bulbasaur. He is last seen north from here. Find Bulbasaur. Just as soon as I... Oh, right. There's no healing at the start of this. Yeah, that can be a problem. Oh, it heals you after the fights. Okay. Or after that fight, anyway. Yeah, it does... I guess it does feel a little weird without, using controller, but... Okay, let me just grab that R coin real quick. Can I go back through the portal? Or am I not allowed to leave yet? There's a few things I want to do in the hub, but... Okay, I can go back. Nice. See, so I gotta go all the way back, and I gotta go to the left, I believe. Oh, would it be in there? I not... Maybe I can't. Maybe I have to finish World 1 first. Now, I could do this. This is like a secret maze thing that I can get a lot of rewards from, but there is a danger to doing it. I don't know if you guys can hear the sound effect, but it's Rhine from Xenoblade Chronicles saying, "Now it's Rhine time!" It used to be, a short clip from The Nightmare Before Christmas, but it was kind of afraid that it would get DMCA'd, so it got swapped over to Rhine saying that. Alright, so I need to go north. So I'm gonna go this way, I guess. Double check that there's nothing down here. Yeah, there is. Dang it. I should probably do some fights anyway. So now that I think about it, I'm not gonna be at full health, which is kind of a problem. Well, it's not really overworld Pokemon necessarily. They're Heartless from Kingdom Hearts in this area. Although you're in the Pokemon world, but the enemies are still Heartless. Because that's like a big theme of Octo's community, and the Heartless are supposedly in every world. So you'll still see them in like Pokemon worlds. Let's see. Kind of worried about Charmander being at half health already when he started at full health. Maybe I'll just do a little attacking with Octo for right now. Try to knock down these Heartless. And then I will guard on Charmander. And of course he gets to go again, so that was kind of useless. Okay, I guess guarding's working out here. Let me skill burn. Soldier has more weaknesses. So, although I can break the I can break the shadow, which might be good. Let me do that first. And now I can use Ember on the... Well, I should actually attack the shadow, because now that he's broken, we're gonna do more damage. Yo! Also, that was a critical. You could tell by the rainbow numbers. That did 278 damage. That was an unnecessary amount of damage. Alright, let me see what the weaknesses on this soldier is. Okay. Lightning, and then fire, hopefully, so I can break the soldier. Oh, that's fine, Rahe. Just, like, hanging out in any way is much appreciated. Alright, let's see if I can finish off the soldier with a normal deck? No, not quite. One more normal attack. And then you're weak to physical, so just physical. I guess it's a different attribute for Charmander. Oh yeah, Octo's weapons has attributes on them, but I don't remember. The party members might be focused to like one, so my health is getting pretty low about on this, and I'm not very happy about that. Yeah, I do have Nico Metal, but it doesn't heal very much now. It scales better, so it's better in endgame. But it used to heal 69 HP at the start, and that was insane. Now it only heals like 30 something. Bad. Maybe I'll hold on the growl for when I need it more. This is physical, right? Yeah, there we go. Oh yeah, I completely forgot to mention that the battle theme is something that I did make, and also this ending theme is his Octo's old YouTube outro. Which, funny enough, the title screen theme is a remix of his new outro, which I made. And I also made the new remix version for this game. So, comes full circle, I guess. I should probably grab that. Endpoint voucher. Oh, I remember now. Yeah, I remember Bulbasaur. A bit worried about my HP being that low, though. Can I grab that item? Gimme! Okay, it's only two shadows. This should be fine. Oh, look, we have the same health. Because that attack missed. Alright, so I can just attack, and then I'll skill, use Scratch. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Oh, wait, Charmander gets like a bajillion turns. Oh, but now he has cooldown. I'm not sure what their other weakness would be. Maybe I'll just use a potion real quick. Maybe one. How much health is that? Oh, cool. I got a miss, too. Wait, double miss? Alright. I'm okay with this game. Skill. That would probably... I lowered the attack by 50%. Nah, I'll try to keep this TP for now. I don't remember what the other weakness is for this. Probably, like, light, I would imagine. But I honestly don't remember what it is. 8 MP, do I care about this? That probably finishes off this shadow. I'm just gonna do that. Oh, not quite. Oh, but he got paralyzed. It's fine. Oh. Oh, okay. There's crit rate. There's agility. Maybe that's... Meh. Whatever, it's fine. It's not that fine because my health is so low already. But... That did a lot of damage. I didn't expect it to do that much damage. Okay, let me use a couple potions before I die. I have 23 potions, this is fine. Oh, it heals 69 HP plus 3% of max. I was wondering why it was that weird amount. Okay, that's fine. Okay, there's Bulbasaur. Maybe I'll fight a little bit here. I don't want to, like, overlevel, but, like... Kind of worried about some early stuff. Okay. Can do that. I think I'll use... Yeah, I think I'll use Growl here. No, I'll just attempt to break that one, I guess. Okay, there we go. Okay, they're weak to physical. They're weak to, like, everything, it seems. Just gonna attack to finish that one off. Ouch. That did a lot of damage. Gonna do that. Break this one. Alright, I should have used Scratch. Oh well. Stop with, like, the low tier crits. Yeah, I feel like with the weak enemies, it's just better to attack them. Let's see. I'm gonna use a couple more potions here. Okay, now we're gonna do this. He already got the news from Squirtle. It seems that he wants to test his strength. Very well, I shall show this Bulbasaur that I have what it takes to learn the ways of the Pika. Let's show Bulbasaur what we're made of, Charmander. Alright, he has one weakness. Lord knows I don't remember what it is, but we're gonna start with this. Actually, it's probably better to save my better attacks for once I actually break him. So... He is weak to fire, though. Razor Leaf. Okay. Do I have, like, fire materia? No, not yet. Bad. I'm just gonna use this. Yeah, you might be right on that, Kaiser. Oh, cool, I can just use Ember again. Alright, so use Ember again, break Bulbasaur, deal damage. Abilities that I definitely can't use because I wasted it. But also, I didn't notice that Fern has a 10-turn cooldown. So... Any... Oh. You can just, like, spam abilities, and there's no cooldown on any of these. That's pretty good. How does he scratch though? Oh, there's like a one turn cooldown on that. Okay. I hope I can at least get through World 1, and then I can show off all the cool things in the hub. I don't really want to stream for too long tonight, because I'm still, like, feeling tired earlier. My schedule is kind of off right now. I want to be going to bed at, like, 12, but I've been going to bed at, like, 10:30, so I don't want to overdo it. Yeah, don't have a whole lot of options on Octo yet. I can fix that soon. That Ember does so much damage. Bobblesir said that still one last test we must undertake before we learn the ways of the Pika. Bring it on! We need to go south and challenge the Pika Tower. We might find some clues on how to get home there. Bulbasaur said that if we need some healing, we can ask him for free heals. And I get Surge the Sharks rarity and Tentametal. Alright, so we can head back to the town. Is there like a shortcut to get through here? Wish there was. Oh yeah, and Squirtle also has a shop. Let me grab this before I forget. Mega Ether. Well, now that I have free heals from Bulbasaur, I shouldn't have to use too many potions. I probably missed an item up there, whatever. I don't remember. I don't remember some of the specific pathways. God. Gonna get lost in this place somehow. I believe I go this way. Alright, let's do this. Guess I want free healing. Thank you. And I want to save. Alright, I think I have to... Yeah. So I can't go that way yet. But what do you sell? he says Octopus like a wolf. What do I want to buy here? I believe I want some light materia, and I want some fire materia. Because a lot of the enemies around here are weak to those. And I can head this way now. Oh yeah, the flipping beach in the Pika Tower. Dang, I wanted that item. Extra thick. Extra thick. Extra thick. Extra thick. Extra thick. Oh yeah, I keep forgetting I can just use Nico because it's instant cast. So that would make a whole lot of sense to do that. Yeah, so, like, I can just heal off the damage I took for free, essentially. Extra. Oh, yeah, it auto-equipped that, too. Lowers defense by 25% for... Oh, this is also instant cast. So I can, like, do combo stuff, which is pretty cool. Do I really need to do this here? Apparently I can just spam Ember. It has, like, no cooldown. So, I guess I'm gonna do that while I have free heals. Let me grab this item. All that for an ether. Yeah. Grab this. High potion. I don't even remember where this goes. I think it's another item you can just, like, jump off. Yeah. Wind materia. Oh, right. You can't jump off. Bad. That's where I need to be. Yeah, it's not... On normal mode, it's not too bad. At least until a little bit later. I don't need to go that way yet. What I do need is to go up here, I think. Yep. Pika Tower. Save game again. So why not? My potion. I don't know. The size of everyone was kind of dependent on the sprites for the game. So, like, some of the characters may appear a lot bigger than others. Hi there, Fern. It seems you have managed to learn the basics of the Pika. Oh, yeah, I did. Learning the ways of the Pika is quite fun and challenging. But that's just the beginning. You still have much to learn, Octo. The final trial awaits here inside the Pika Tower. But before you can proceed, I need you to do a fetch quest. Shiver me. Timber pirate opening Octo. Here we go again. It's a really simple errand. While I was kicking demonetization all around the place. I think it's funnier to say kicking demonetization all over the place. I have stumbled upon a portal to another world. Nico Thief was even there, but sadly she doesn't recognize me. Yeah, I actually woke up there and here I am. Not a single clue where I am and where to go next. Fear not, Octo. When I was exploring that lush forest, I found a small cave to the west. Nico Thief said that place was called the Gotcha Lands. Ah, here we go. You might want to check it out because it has the word gotcha on it. You might even get more powerful with your streamer luck, you salty puss. Alright, I guess we're gonna go back to that place and check out this Gotcha Lands. I was waiting for this. Well, I shall be waiting on top of the Pika Tower in the meantime. By the way, we should call that area the Tenta Hub. What? To the Tenta Hub. One of my favorite areas in the whole game. I feel like it just wouldn't be the same if the Gotcha Lands didn't exist in this game. Yeah, Materia is really good in this game because when you can get that broken status, you can do so many, like, combos and follow-ups. It's so good. Now it's rhyme time! Oh yeah, you can also, like, test out combos on Training Dummy there. This place. Sock Puppet Donald. No, I am not Donald. I am Dolan. the Gacha Master. I oversee the Gacha lands and all its treasures. Honestly, though, can we appreciate that this sock puppet that's been a meme for years in Octa's community has, like, spam ton energy now? Because you'll see in a minute here in some of the dialogue. You're looking at the perfect guy when it comes to gachas. Perfect! Feel free to sign over here so that we can proceed. What am I signing for? That darling gacha enterprises has no way, shape, or form responsible for salt-inducing gacha results, as well as no refunding of valuable temp coins that you may or may not get through easier, hard-earned means. I don't know about this, Octo. Contract looks fishy to me. Well, I'm gonna need all the sentimentals I can if I want to find my way back home. Brian recommends his ducks, and so be it. Thank you for signing. You are now a big shot. I mean, please accept this complimentary tentacoins and this tentametal for your troubles. May you get salty or happy on your results. So you get a self rarity end medal. 5,000 tentacoins. And talk to me when you want to pull in the gacha wheels. The freaking gacha wheels. And Octo Connection coins, too. There's a lot of the combat in this room. Yo, you get an SSR coin off the bat. That's pretty hype. And yes, it plays this music, too. Best music in this game. Where's my sock pop at Donald emojis? No. I can't post them on YouTube. Oh, well. Okay, so the way this works is you can pull on these wheels using tentacoins, and you can get different rarities of metals which have better effects. There's like different wheels that have better chances of stuff, and then feeling lucky is just like one square that gets you the highest ranking and everything else gives you nothing. But, okay, fine. I'll do the feeling lucky wheel once just to show what it looks like because it's awesome. But otherwise, I'm not gonna be using this a whole lot, probably. See, look at this wheel. It's literally sock puppet Donald on it with nothing but death symbols and one good symbol. Which, if I somehow hit, is gonna be amazing. Bruh! What the flip? How did I do that? Oh my god, I'm a freaking god. How did I do that? Who needs save scum when you're just a god? I just pulled like a 1 in 50 chance. Oh my god, I'm gonna clip that and send it to Octo later. Alright, well, we're gonna save that outcome. Alright. Cool. I love being a god. Alright, god gamer. Anyway, let me go into this room real quick. Only the highest of rarity. Oh. Nightpot, why are you still here? Why do you still haunt me? Timed out for 5 seconds. Hold on. Sorry, Nightbot timed you out. I should really, like... Hold on. I have a different bot for this, so I'm gonna remove moderator on Nightbot so it can't do that. I have no idea how I did that. So! SSR medals are the highest ranking medal, and I can get two of them right now because I have two SSR coins. And as I said before, there is a lot of medals, but also I have to point this one out real quick, including my own, of course, which you know I'm going to pick up, but I don't know if I want to get right away because I have like the status effect metal, or status effect, restoring metal, and it's good for, like, later bosses, but there's not too many enemies that use a lot of statuses in the beginning. The one that I really want to buy that will probably make this game free is... I don't know the order of these, though. Hold on. DJ Kirby, I believe. DJ Kirby's metal is like an AoE hit, and I'm pretty sure it would eviscerate most enemies early game at SSR. So I'm gonna buy this. Yes, I want to redeem this metal. I could just save Scum if I'm mistaken on this, but I believe it's DJ Kirby's. That's the AoE hit. So let me check that out real quick. Equip skills. Stores HP based on luck. Target all allies. So I'm going to swap out Surge, and I'm going to put on SSR DJ Kirby. Target all enemies. Deals 2-hit magic damage. Applies Kirby Tap, which amplifies magic damage dealt by 5%. But who cares? It boosts my magic attack by 10. It has an 8-turn cooldown, but if I'm one-turning enemies, it doesn't matter. So, as long as I can afford the cost of it, this is gonna make the game so free if I want to use this. There is something I'm gonna grab besides that, though. I'm not gonna grab another SSR medal yet. I just think Kirby's will probably be good enough for right now. And I don't really know what else I want to grab. There's actually, like, a whole medal sheet made up with what they all do. But I only remember a few of them off the top of my head, so I'll have to refer to that later. What I am gonna do, I'm gonna go over to our medals. And I'm going to grab my own medal, because, yes, if I'm going to have a medal in my game for myself, I may as well at least buy it at R Rarity. Alright, so, skill. I don't think I want to unequip anything yet, though. So my medal, everyone... Yeah, it has a 5-turn cooldown, but it has instant cast, which means you can use another metal right after it. And it provides debuff resistance to one ally for 3 turns. So, in, like, harder enemies that actually use a whole bunch of debuffs, it's actually going to come in handy to have that. So, that's my story, and I'm sticking to it. I may try this out just to see how busted it is. I'm gonna switch out Surge for DJ Kirby, and I'm gonna go into a regular fight and see if I can see how much it does. Okay, it costs 24 MP though, so that's pretty hefty. Nico's instant cast, but so is my metal. But there's not a lot of statuses, so Nico's probably better right now. Also, Taskmaster's is similar to mine, but it's all allies. But it's not instant cast, I believe. And it has a higher burn rate, so you can't use it as much. So, a whole bunch of things to consider with all these medals. It's not really a game about collecting Pokemon, unfortunately. It's more of like a typical RPG thing where you battle enemies. But there is a Pokemon world, which is what you saw earlier. But it has like RPG style fighting in it. And not really like Pokemon catching, unfortunately. That would have been wild if every world had like a different style of combat. But RPG maker limitations, maybe. Actually, forget RPG limitations, just time limitations. Here, because we have free heals on Bulbasaur, I'm gonna try out Kirby on this training dummy. Oh yeah, I guess the dummy can do different things too. So, this one will just wait and not do anything. What happens if you die in a training dummy fight, I wonder? Okay, we're gonna use skill, and we're gonna try this DJ Kirby metal. It does 2 hits of magic damage, and I believe it does insane damage. Yeah, it does like, it does 200 damage to all enemies already. So, that's insane for like a first turn move, or a move to use after I've broken the enemy. So, that's gonna be ridiculous later. It has like a game over screen, and it plays this hilarious clip of Sully from Charted, or from Uncharted, saying, "Oh my god, no!" I should actually show that off real quick. Hold on. Let me save here again. And then I'm gonna go intentionally die somewhere just to show that game over screen off. Actually, I'm gonna try to on the training dummy and see if I can actually die to the training dummy. Attack dummy. Does he actually attack? Yeah, he does. Oh, that's gonna take forever though. Let me go to a different enemy. Oh, what do you mean I was unable to escape? What do you mean? Okay. I was about to say, if I was stuck in that fight, I would have been very unhappy. Alright, let's go back to... Oh yeah, it's freaking great. Honestly, I could just go into the, Pika Tower. Now it's runtime! Since that's so quiet, I'm just gonna say it every time, too. The Pika Tower has a pretty... some stronger enemies in it, so... I can just intentionally die in it. And hopefully not actually die in it. Alright, so I'm gonna heal. I'll just save over at the Pika Tower. Also, the music in the Pika Tower is 10 out of 10. Alright, best music. Wait. Can I not? Okay, I was gonna say. Dang it. Wanted to try to get by there without triggering that. Well, on plus side, I can test out my Kirby medal, I guess. Alright, I just want to see how busted this is on actual enemies. Yeah, that's like half, that's half their health already. And then I can just like follow it up with Ember. And it'll also scale with, It'll also scale with, like, level and stats and stuff, too. So, also, I get 5% of... I get to do more magic damage for 3 turns. Use this real quick. And also... Oh, but that uses... I guess that uses a lot of MP, so... Oh, that's pretty interesting. I can go... Yeah, I can use this, and then I can combo into Nico's metal, which heals more based on luck. So, huh. Oh, why didn't it do that again? What? Stop closing. Window capture is literally turning itself invisible. I guess I'll... I'm gonna lock it and see if that helps. Fern? Why are we fighting? Foolish human. You thought it was Fern. But it was me, Diochu, all along. Do I have a medal list? I could probably go find it. I don't know where it is. It's somewhere in the development server at the moment. It's me, Diochu. You had to get the JoJo references in there. There's also like a secret Octopus that's also a JoJo reference. But this face though, this is the face of pure just intimidation. Anyway.
Your life and dear, you smelly sea creature.
Ah, there it is. Yep, that's the one.
Oh, are you approaching me?
I don't appreciate being paralyzed. You know, maybe bringing my metal here may have been a good idea. I'm just gonna drop that real quick. I'm gonna save that until I find a way to break Fern. With maybe Earth Materia or something, but I'll try some of these other ones first. I don't want to use this yet. I don't really want to use that yet either. I'm just gonna normal attack. And then I'll try out some weaknesses on here. Also, I may try Growl. Attack by 50% for 5 turns. Yeah, that's fine. Actually, wait. Did I want to intentionally die here first? I guess there is, like, a save right after this. So... okay, we're spamming normal attacks until we die. Wow, he's really targeting Charmander. He got Iron Tail. Ow. There's no way I'm gonna trigger Fern just with normal attacking, right? Okay. No. Rip. And rip. Okay, now you get to see the game over screen. It starts with this. And then...
Oh my god, no!
It's a little quiet, though, because the other music is so freaking loud. Maybe I should have turned it up maybe a little bit. Oh well. And then it actually brings you back to the starting menu. Alright. Once more with more Diochu energy.
But it was me, Diochu.
Oh, are you approaching me? Oh, you paralyzed Charmander this time, huh? I don't know if I'm happy about that. Alright, since we tried out regular attack, let's try out some of these materia. It's probably Earth materia, right? I would imagine. Also, I guess I'll throw on Growl. I'll throw this on. And then... I'll try Ember out first. Nope, didn't think so. Alright, let's try this Earth Materia Plus. Yep, there it is. Alright, now I can go to town. We can go Ember. 251. And then we can bust out DJ Kirby. Yep. Even though I barely have enough MP for it, we're gonna do it. This is actually, like, a terrible metal to use. It's supposed to be for AoE, but still does, like, 300 damage. So, it's fine, I guess. Then we're gonna Ember again. Maybe I'll break out an ether here. Alright, Browse before off. Maybe the Ember. So will we use Fern on Fern? Or Fern on DO2? Of course, that does no damage. Still paralyze them somehow, though. I think Growl wore off because that's doing more damage. So... since I don't... well, I can... yeah, I can use Nico real quick. And because that's insta-cast, I'll follow it up with Guard. And then... I'll use up the rest of my MP, and then I'll probably drop an Aether on Charmander. Actually, yeah, that would be... If I want to make Octo a defensive player, I could give him my medal. Just drop it on an ally so that they have debuff immunity, and then I can just guard on him so he takes 50% less damage. That might not be bad if I could, like, debuff immune one of the offensive party members later. That could actually get kind of insane. So they could consistently deal high damage. So I might experiment with that. Oh, also there is an escape option if you hit back on this menu as well, which is kind of weird, but... yeah, unfortunately, I didn't make this either because I didn't get into working on music for this until after, like, the intro part. Because Nico kind of went ahead and did, like, the first two worlds on her own. But Nico has impeccable music taste, so even this song is an absolute jam. Honestly, I'm kind of tempted just to guard again. Oh, wait, I get an extra turn because of it. That's totally worth. I'm just gonna let Charmander can handle this. Oh. Well, when you put it that way. Before I go into the next part here, I'm gonna... wait, how do I do that? I'm gonna use this on Charmander real quick. And I'm gonna regular attack to finish off Fern. Fern! Oh. That didn't finish him off. Sad. Well, he just got two turns that I didn't expect him to get. Charmander, you good? Well, that kind of sucks. I didn't expect that to happen, actually. Sure. True. Yeah, it does kind of look like we're floating. Pixel HP. Forgot it existed. What did you do to Fern? He's sitting pretty somewhere and I'm never going to tell you. What's happening? I feel... powerful. I reject my humanity to Octo. I become heartless Dio. You're not even human. Suddenly, giant dark side from Kingdom Hearts boss. This music feels different. The music playing here, I'm pretty sure was not what I heard in the original playthrough. Interesting. Still pretty good, though. Kind of insane for, like, this World 1 boss, but... what? Yeah, I wonder what... I should look at the credits a little closer. Wait, do we actually... I guess I'll use this. Try to paralyze Darkseid. Yeah, paralyze. It lowers... How the hell did we beat this thing, Charmander? You must believe in the power of friendship. Because our friends are our power. Our friends are our power, cliche. Signed... Chari 5, I guess. Another reactor on... Or another content creator on YouTube. This music is so insane. Holy flip. I don't remember it being this crazy in the first... In the first playthrough I watched. Although my health is actually, like, really low right now. Hold on. I'm gonna growl and try to survive this. I don't know if we can really beat this thing. Okay, here we go. I hope this is not one of those games where if I die in the game, I die in real life. Hands off my friends. Ayo, who dis? Even though I know who it is. The Keyblade Hero of Light and Darkness has joined the fray. It's not quite Sora in Smash, but it is Roxas in Project Octopus. Now it's my turn. Roxas recovered all of Smelly Octopus's party's HP and MP. Oh, that's... And this is where your third party member comes in with the ultimate badass Kingdom Hearts music. Alright, 8 attacks to break this thing. I bet... Light Materia. Yeah, that's the weakness. That's why I bought 4 of it. With Roxas here, there's no way we're losing now. Because we got all these abilities here. I can enchant an item shortcut. Oh, I forget. I didn't realize the instant cast on Supreme Potions was here. Interesting. Okay. Okay, so if I recall correctly. We can go combo, link, finish, and if you do these in order, then you get more benefits and it works out better. So we're gonna focus thrust, and of course critical, because if I recall, Roxas is like a crit god, even though Nico supposedly worked on that. I'm not gonna use that yet. We're gonna... Actually, I'm just gonna drop another light materia. I should have bought like 10 light materia. But, oh well. Oh yeah, Charmander has like a really high turn rate, by the way. He gets like double turns half the time because he has so many turns. Or he's so fast. Alright, so then we use Horizontal Slash. Roxas is doing a lot of damage here. Octo doesn't get really strong until later because once his stats scale up, his offensive metals do so freaking much damage. But I kind of want to build Octo as a defensive player. So my build's going to be a lot different than what Octo did because Octo himself, the streamer, built his character to be more offensive focused. But I think with, like, knowing all the party members, I think I can make it work with Octo defense, and he's still going to be just as busted. Because I know how powerful some of the party members can actually get for dealing damage. Let's see. Everyone's taking damage, so I'm going to drop this... Well, I'm going to drop the Nico medal on somebody. Probably Roxas. And I'm going to drop... his medal on everyone to heal them. Which increases our luck, so I have higher chance of critical. And then I can drop Stun Impact for the finisher. It does 470 damage, which is pretty good, actually. Do I want to use DJ Kirby here? I don't know if I'm going to get the chance to break him. Because I didn't buy enough materia to do it. So, I don't really have enough light hits to do that. But what I am going to use instead is Event Horizon. One enemy deals it does 9 hits of light damage. Never mind, we're going to be able to break him easily with this. 9 hits of light damage. Regains MP for 4 turns. Light enchants all of his attacks, which I should have used first, honestly, if I was really thinking about this. And ignores defense value on this attack, so it's going to do mass damage. Yeah, look at that damage. And it breaks him, so now I can follow it up with DJ Kirby. Now he's broken. Yeah, 300 damage in there. And then I can break out... Ember will do more damage. 257. And then he's still stunned. I gotta wait one more time for his full combo. I think I have to wait one more turn. So I'm going to normal attack for now. Oh yeah, I forgot. He also gets double attack. So Roxas can attack twice. So he can deal like 600 damage on his regular attack, even in this fight. Plus it's light enchanted, so the enemy is weak to it on top of that. So it's pretty wild. Like when you start really getting into the combat, you can do all sorts of like cool buff stacking and stuff to really deal out the damage. It's pretty nice. I'm gonna use an Aether here because Octo is really just playing like a support role. Now that we have Charmander and Roxas, they can deal the damage, and I might actually equip my own metal. Just to give them, like, debuff protection and make Octo a defensive player. At least until we get the World 3, then I might have some decisions to make about who's playing defense. Yeah, I heard Irish Eyes is a really good metal, too. Oh, that lowered my defense. Feels bad. I can't really do it. See, here's the problem. I can't do a lot on Octo because everything has cooldowns. So, and his normal attack isn't very good yet because I can't hit attributes. Besides the one that he has right now. Spoiler alert, you do get... different attribute weapons on Octo later, just to be able to hit weaknesses easier. But early game Octo is kind of bad unless you buy a whole bunch of metals for him, specific metals to swap out. So I'm just gonna guard on him, and I'll let Charmander and Roxas handle this. Okay, so I could go through his combo again. Let me see. Let me look at his buffs real quick. Does he still have the double attack? Enchant normal attacks with light element. He does still have that. Increases number of normal attacks by 1. Okay. Increased damage and effects. Combo starter will have increased damage and effects. Okay. So. I could do his combo starter or... I could just attack twice. If I attack twice, it's gonna do like, what, 400 damage maybe, and then break him, and then knock his break counter down twice. So I might just do that right now. Yeah, that did like 550 damage. And then I could do Growl again here soon. Can critical. Grants Pyro Magic for 3 turns. He's already burned, though, I think, so I'm just gonna do that. I'm gonna do Scratch. And then he can go again because it's high turn rate, and now he has Growl because we moved his turn rate up. So now the enemy is burned, their attack is lowered, looking pretty good. And now I believe I can... Yep, totally... Oh, I can finally use Charmander's EX. Oh, that's... Ooh, but do I wait for Roxas to... break him again first? Nah, he doesn't have that much health first. Alright, check this out. Charmander's EX deals 4 fire hits of magic damage, ignores defense, Inflicts Burn, adds Flames of Rebirth to Charmander for 3 turns. And it does, I believe, a whole lot of damage. So we're gonna do this right now. EX Blast Burn, baby. Oh, it doesn't do that much damage, sadness. But what's this buff that he got? Flames of Rebirth. Enchants normal attack with fire element, lowers MP cost rate by 50%, and enables Aerith Downs to have instant cast. So he can revive people without losing his turn, and then he can use his regular attacks with less MP cost for... Is that only, like, one round? I don't know how long any of these last. No, it's for 3 rounds. Because it's, like, the orange icon. Okay. I should probably be... This is something that Octo neglected a whole lot. You can mouse over all of these to, like, see what their debuffs are. And Octo neglected to do that a lot during his playthrough. So... let's see. Yeah. Yeah, Blast Burn in actual Pokemon is insane. So it does similar insane stuff in Project Octopus because it's his EX ability, which is like one of his stronger abilities. I guess I can drop Nico Thief onto Octo. Because here's the thing about Octo. He can, like, drop Nico Thief or My Metal. Actually, he could drop both. He can Nico Thief My Metal because they're both instant cast. And then he could guard to take 50% less damage. And once we get the SSR of all of those, it can get crazy what I can do turn one to protect people on Octo. Just with Octo. So, I know, seems pretty good that he can have a bajillion different instant cast defensive abilities. So, I might want to experiment with that. Also, there's an item in, like, late game, and this is also spoilers, but there's an item in late game that enables you to act twice, but you take more damage and you deal less damage. So, I was thinking on a defensive unit, that would be really good because you can offset the damage you take with guarding, and you can, you don't need to worry about attacking because you're just going to be defending all the time anyway. So Octo with a bunch of instant cast defensive metals and double action, just like drop all of my defensive debuffs first round, not worry about anything, and then just combo stack for the rest of my party for 3 turns, or however long my immunities last. I don't know, to me that sounds pretty good, so I might try that later. Anyway, we're gonna go through these again. Yeah, you don't really get a whole lot of ether just going around, so. I have more light materia, right? Doesn't really pay to use it, though, because the only thing that can break him is Roxas's EX. I don't have anything to restore materia, or tension points. Again, I just feel like guarding on Octo because I can't do anything useful until later. All right, we're gonna go through the order on this. 346. Dark type blast. Maybe we'll do less to Octo. Let's see. Charmander's MP is looking kind of low, but we should have enough. Oh yeah, because it's 50% less. And his buff enables Aerith Downs to have instant cast. Enchants normal attack with fire element. Is that... That doesn't really do anything for me right now. Actually, you know, I'm kind of cool with just guarding on Octo because I can use Nico into Smelly Octopus, and that's like a double heal for the party. So, kind of fine with just guarding on Octo still. Stun Impact. 43. Ember. I'm just gonna spam Ember while I have the half MP. Guard. I'm getting a lot of turns in a row. I don't know if it's because I'm using high turn rate things. I know, guarding also increases your turn rate, so you can perform an action quicker on that character. So, if you're trying to take turns quickly to reduce cooldown on your abilities while also dodging damage, that's pretty good. Alright, normal attack. I guess I'll use Scratch this time. Hey, crit. that's Charmander again. Oh, I'm out of MP. Yeah, I have a couple others still. I'll drop one on Charmander. We're gonna guard. And we're gonna... Can't quite go through the full combo, so I'm gonna double attack again. Dark Side Blast. Yeah, you see how Octo is taking like 45 compared to the other party members are taking almost 100. Guarding is like actually insane. Alright, I have just an. Alright, I have enough MP now to finish this guy off. With Ember. Yep, Ember did it. GG. Also, Roxas is at level 13 when you get him, so he's kind of beefy boy. Roxas! Sup? I can't believe what's happening right now. Me neither, Octo. I was actually on my way to my body in Keyblade Graveyard when I heard a familiar cry for help. You arrived at the perfect moment. Thanks. No problem. Oh, wait. There is a problem. What's the problem? I don't know how to get back. Well, I guess you're stuck here with me for the time being. I'm sure Zara, Donald, Goofy, Mickey, Sheon, Axel, Baby Shark, doo-doo-doo-doo-doo, Aqua, Terra, all the characters of Kingdom Hearts. And last but not the least, Kairi, because she's the most important character in Kingdom Hearts. I'm not even going to ask why you know all of them, nor how or why you know me. That's for the better. We don't want this world to be as complicated as Kingdom Hearts plot. Right. So what's the plan, Octo? We search for Fern. He's our friend and I must save him. Octo, the tentacle keyblade is glowing. Magic powers. Did we look around? Glad to have you in the team, Roxas. And with newfound confidence, I feel like I could disturb a mouse meowth or two. Create a new ten of medals for him to use. Roxas and Charmander medals have been obtained. And that is... Well, that's not all of World 1, but I think that's where I'm going to stop on World 1 for tonight. Oh, you know what I can actually do? Oh, I just thought of something I can do, but first things first, before I go, I'm gonna change my metal lineup. We're gonna go to skill. I really didn't build up enough TP to use Enta Flash all this time, which is kind of sad. But we're gonna swap. What are we gonna do here? I might go buy another metal real quick before I go. Or before I end. Alright, so I'm gonna talk to Bulbasaur. I will definitely take that healing. I have Roxas in the party now. And there's a whole bunch of things I can do later to upgrade my party. But right now, I just want to go and grab... Oh, what metal do I want to grab, though? I have to think about this. I might actually have to go find the medal list before I end. So that's pretty interesting. We're gonna go back to the Gotcha Lands. Oh, hey, Nico. I can't do 24-hour streams. You should know this by now. But, like, I was about to end my stream for tonight, but, like, since you're here now, totally gonna continue for another few minutes. Well, actually, I was gonna continue and try to figure out my metal lineup for later on. I just finished World 1, so... Oh, you should have seen it earlier. I did an RNG roll on the Zetaflare wheel. No, I did it on the Feeling Lucky wheel, and I actually got it first try. I was dying of laughter when that happened. I'm totally gonna make a clip of that and send it to Octo. God tier gamer luck. Got the Feeling Lucky wheel first try. Oh, you have. That's pretty neat, then, actually. I freaking can't believe that happened. Alright, so... I have another SSR medal I could use. Why do we have... That's not something I can equip to... Why is that in my inventory? What can I do with... Why is this just in my inventory and not equipped to anybody? That's kind of... That's weird. Or is it equipped? Was that just blind and I didn't equip it somehow? Many questions. Oh. Forgot that was a thing I probably should have done way before this. We're not gonna talk about that. I didn't realize you just, like, get that in your inventory and it doesn't come equipped. Unless you get it... Not when you get the character unlocked. And I just, like, missed it. Yeah, I don't have any accessories yet. Yeah, I can't believe that. What is that, Nico? Like, a 1 in 30-something odd chance? I don't know how many symbols you put on that wheel, but... By the way, Nico in the chat right now is the one who actually programmed all of, like, Project Octopus that I'm playing right now. So, huge shout-outs to her for building this amazing game. Alright, let me... I wanted to look at what... coins I have here. I don't know if I want to get that SSR coin yet. I don't have the medal list up, so I might want to double check some of the things I can get before I just buy this. I bought DJ Kirby's medal just because it seemed like a solid AoE that could help me out through the entire game. But besides that, I really want to look over the medal list before I make any decisions. Yeah, 1 out of 30. I don't know what I want to do. The only thing that I did just from the start, just because, like, I kind of had to, is I bought my medal right away in R rarity. Just because I had a coin for it. So what I was kind of thinking for Octo's build, since Octo went... you're here, like, most of the time. You probably heard my explanations on it. But I'm gonna build Octo defensive and see if I can make his party members work. Because from watching his playthroughs, I know his future party members can do insane damage. I mean... Granted, when you get, like, the form above EX for Octo, try not to spoil too much here, but when you get the powers above EX for Octo, he can pretty much just, like, absolutely vomit damage onto enemies, but I don't know. I feel like I want to play differently than what Octo did when he was streaming it. So I want to go defensive. Yeah, I was thinking maybe instead of doing the double attack thing with Kirby like I wanted to initially, I could do it with Octo and just give him like a whole bunch of instant cast medals, and then give him one other medal that's not instant cast that he can use to protect the party, and then he can just guard. So he'll have like debuff immunity. He can give with Kazmaster, he could like give debuff immunity to the party. He could do two different instant casts, and then he could guard on top of that if he had the double cast. So like the actual attackers of the party couldn't get debuffed, and then they could just combo off and do their thing while Octo's just sitting there as tanky boy, guarding every turn if he needs to, so that the bonus damage from the double attacking isn't really an issue. So that's kind of my plan for this when we get there. I have a lot of stuff to do before we get to that point, but that's going to be my end build plan, I guess. I'm also going to... I really want to run, what is it? Solator? Is that their name? I'm probably, like, name-dropping party members that I shouldn't right now, but, like... Solier, was it? I really liked the defensive abilities they had, and I really think having two tanks and then two heavy hitters is going to be the way to go in this. I mean, Octo could still, like... I could maybe run one just, like, really insane offensive battle on him. Low-key, just run Tyler for, like, the RNG instant death chance. So while he's, like, spam defending whenever the cooldown is up on that, I can just drop it and try to get some lucky kills. That'd be funny. And then Solier has, like, all sorts of insane healing and buff abilities, and then I can... I don't know, though, because I don't know if I want to run Kirby or Solier as the second tank, and then I probably want to pick two other members for the attackers. So, I'm going to have a lot of decisions to make along the way in this. But, I think for right now, I'm going to call it quits, even though a true gamer would stay up, like you said, Nico, for another 24 hours and stream this. I am unfortunately not a true gamer, and I'm instead a very tired gamer. So, I'm gonna call it quits for right now. But, on the plus side, even though this is YouTube, we can go raid Octo if he's still streaming. I just have to go grab his Twitch link real quick, and then we can all unofficially raid him. Assuming he's still streaming at the moment. Oh, no, he's... Wait, is he not and he didn't announce it? Hold on. Did he actually start streaming and he didn't announce it? No. Unless he ended already, which is also possible. Alright. Well, yeah. I guess I'm good then. Thank you so much everyone for watching. I'll probably be back. I have a lot to do tomorrow, so maybe like Tuesday I'll be back playing more Project Octopus. I want to at least minimum get through a world per stream, I think. And it's not going to be like Octo where he'll be looking at everything for the first time, so I'm hoping it'll go maybe a little bit faster so I can actually get through the worlds without streaming for a bajillion hours. But yeah, this game is awesome. All the references in it, all the characters from series that I also love. Even the even the combat has, like, so many options. I'm gonna have to really think about what to do for my build. So, I'll be looking more into that next time. I don't think, I'm not gonna do that much grinding off stream. I think I'll just, like, do whatever. I'm not gonna be like Octo and come back and have a bajillion health and stuff like that. And, like, 100,000 money currency. I can't believe he did that. But anyway, I guess I'll see you all on Tuesday then. I wish I had a good night stream and, or not a good night stream, jeez. A good night screen, but unfortunately I am unprofessional streamer that just has epic Octo game to end on. So I'll see you all on the next adventure and hopefully I will have the energy to do it. Have a good night.